I had made my decision before all the rumors and all that started. So yeah, everybody tries to make it about that, but it wasn't.
It wasn't. Is there anything that you miss about Southern Charm?
Is there anything I miss? I mean, it was such a, I have nothing but positive things to say about my experience doing it. I originally signed on thinking it would be on maybe a year or two. I never in my wildest dreams thought it would last 7 seasons. So it's been a wildly successful show. But I don't have any regrets. Would I do anything differently? No, I wouldn't.
Yeah, I've talked to Craig, I've talked to Shep, and I've talked to Austin all throughout this season. And Craig told us that he thinks he can convince you to come back.
Oh, yeah. He texted me the other day. He's like, what would it take for you to come back, Cam? I'm like, oh, God, I don't know. I think that chapter is closed. I really just feel like I don't fit anymore in the mix. It started to feel a little forced for me. Okay. And just inauthentic. And I don't want to be on reality TV and feel like I have to act or feel like I have to be a certain way to fit in. And I do keep my family private and just started to feel a little hypocritical for me to stay on.
Mm-hmm. Were you always planning on leaving before this past season?
Yes. Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
I had made my decision before all the rumors and all that started. So yeah, everybody tries to make it about that, but it wasn't.
It wasn't. But I mean, have you watched this back this season at all?
No, you know, we actually, we have Disney Plus and Netflix. So we don't even have Bravo anymore, but Whitney sent me one. I watched one episode and oh Lord, it's a lot.
It was a lot. And I know, you know, speaking of the rumors, did you ever talk to Catherine after everything that happened?
No, I never talked to her about it. You know, I ultimately let it go. Mm-hmm. And I chalked it up to, at the end of the day, I try to be a realist. Trying to be a realist about reality television. Right. This is what you sign up for. There's a lot of positives that come out of it. It gives you a platform. Like I wrote a book and I'm talking to you because I was on Southern Charm. But the negatives are stuff like this happens. There's rumors started. There's all this vitriol and fighting, and that's part of the reason that I had to get out of it. So yeah. In a sense, I get it. It's par for the course, you know.
Right. But I mean, it had to be hurtful because you obviously you've known her for so many years.
Yes, it was definitely hurtful. But you know, fighting about it. I said my piece to Catherine, obviously, but mm-hmm. keeping it going is what does that accomplish? You
right.
know?
Yeah. So you have no regrets about not going on the show and kind of saying your side of everything as well?
No, because I think that's what they wanted me to do.
So. Yes, totally. You got it. I mean, obviously you're probably still really good friends with Craig and with Shep.
Yes.
That they're going to settle down with their girlfriends?
You know, I was talking to Shep 2 days ago. He's like, Cameron, you've got to meet Taylor. And I still mm-hmm. have not met her because of, you know, I'm very COVID crazy cautious. Mm-hmm. I really don't leave my house. COVID is like rampant in South Carolina right now. But when COVID is over and I'm vaccinated, I cannot wait to meet both Natalie and Taylor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, totally. And then what do you think about Austin? Like I know you said that you haven't really been keeping up this season, but what do you think about Austin and Madison finally ending their relationship?
Oh gosh. Who knows? They have been back and forth for so long. They'll be back together next week, probably.
So you haven't been keeping up with all their drama?
No, God.
I mean, would you ever go back to reality TV in a different capacity, maybe?
Maybe. You know, reality TV has just, it's changed so much. I think especially in the last few years, it's gotten a lot more toxic and a lot, I feel like as a society, we are shocked by less and less. So it has to get more and more to stay relevant and to stay on air. And I don't know, I think there, my prediction, I think there's gonna be a shift in reality television soon, maybe in the next 5 years, where I think people are starting to kind of get sick and tired of all the mean and nasty.
Totally agree with you.
But there's so much of it in the world right now. And people wanna, obviously you want drama and entertainment, but I want to be able to turn on the TV and like laugh and be uplifted. And I hope it morphs more that way in the future.
Yeah,